Hello, all greetings. This is Gilles Mancier. I wanted to come and say hello, wish you a good day. I hope you're enjoying this day for today. Every day is a beautiful day. It has to be the most beautiful day of your life. Each and every day there is new magic, miracle potential that will make it for we've been through a very, very long process to get here. Sometimes it may still be like a roller coaster, a bumpy ride, but it's all gonna be stabilized, it's all gonna be harmonized, it's all gonna be everything is in the works for life to start this new beginning, all kinds of things. So it is a time of test, it is a time of exams for all the things that of the darkness needs to be come to the surface. So do not judge yourself, even if you make two steps forward and you make one step backwards, you go back to the old cycle. Do not judge yourself, understand it is your process and let it go and move, continue to move forward. Do not let yourself judge yourself or blame yourself or feel guilt for moving backwards. For some time we need to move backwards in order to have the determination to continue this path forward. And so once all the choices have been made, there is no more choices to make. You are aligned with the divine will. You are aligned with your higher soul plan. You no longer doubt. You no longer hesitate in relationship to what you have to do. And to manifest this divine will is just to include to have the highest good of all at heart, to your highest good and the highest good of all. For that is the divine will. And then from there, you know you are aligned. I'm going to pull a few cards to see what the highest wisdom for us today surround. It's about letting go of the old. For the old has been let go, and now it is about a new earth, a new beginning, a new self. It is like a contraction of this baby, this spirit. We do not know what's going to be happening, but we have to trust that the new will be so much transcendental of the old. What we need to understand is the pathfinder. It is the pathfinder guide. It's how to navigate through the circumstances of our life in a way that will free ourselves from the old cycle. What we need to do is the master guide. We need to connect to our master guide. It is a spirit being, a celestial being that is assisting us in relationship to our higher ascension path. And so those beings are really on a much higher frequency. So it's like, from the higher frequency, they see everything that's going on down here, and they are guiding, assisting us. The more we are able to give permission to our guides to interact with us, to assist us, to work with us, the more they will be able to become present in our consciousness. And they are essential spirit, parts of our spiritual family. For we are moving from third dimension to the astral plane in the fourth dimension. We're going to reach the fifth dimension, which is the connecting point of all things, and then we move into the sixth dimension, which is allow us to move into this recognition of eternity and immortality as we are able to manifest in more than one timeline at the time. And then we find our apex in the seventh dimension, where we're going to become master of light. We're going to become master of ourselves, and at which point we'll become a flexible body. We'll still have a form. We still have form within this ascension. But we already exist within those dimensions. It's just we have to reconnect our consciousness as we imagine and connect and sort all over those dimensions. There is part of us that becoming aware there, and the connection is being made, and so the light can come down, and we can integrate the codes of each dimension. For each dimension has new rule, new codes, new understanding that needs to be mastered. And in the seventh dimension we reach the apex of individual ascension, at which point we can reach the portal of infinity on the bottom, on the sub part of the eighth dimension. And we move through that portal, we connect to our to all our soul family, our soul group, our monad, where we formulated the plans for our evolution. And then we can ascend to the ninth dimension, where all the divine beings of light are aligning all the soul plans with the divine plan of God, the divine will of unified consciousness. And so the ninth dimension we should try to reach the fifth dimension, but the ninth dimension should be our goal for our work with masters from that dimension that are assisting me in that process. And so for many of our guys are beyond all those dimensions, of course, but they are able to move through their consciousness through different levels to assist us on every path of the way. And the outcome will be a paradigm shift. There is a great deal of shifting. Everything is being changed. Everything is new. Everything is fresh. Everything is recreated. Do not feel distraught if you are having... It's important to find these times to meditate, to pause yourself, to make silence in your mind. It takes 20 minutes each and every day, whether it will, or half an hour, whether it works or not. To do that, to take the time to silence your mind as much as possible, using deep breathing to concentrate, focus on your breath. But right now the energy is so intense that maybe sometimes it's hard to concentrate, or we wake up tired, or take naps if you can, or we have to change our diet, we have a hard time to concentrate, we have a hard time. So there may be some symptom, physical symptom. For there is a great deal of shifting, and do not let whatever comes up, let it come up and release it if it's not positive. Focus and bring your own light and love into this energy if it is what is really wanted. For there is a code that is very important, the 1111 Stargate. It is the point of it is a Stargate that can move through. But there is the 1011. When you see 1011 in the morning or 1011 at night, it is also a Stargate, a portal that will open to this ascension, that will lead us to this 1111. So you work with the code. There is a mantra that you want to work with. It's 0010110. Remember that code, focus on that code, think of that code. Whenever you feel anything that can be troublesome, just bring that code into your life. 0010110, 0010110. It's an easy 7-number digit that can, whenever you bring this into alignment, it clears up the program and connects you to the multidimensional matrix. It's a code that was given to us to assist in the collective ascension, 0010110. So remember that code, repeat it to yourself whenever you need, and see how much it feels, how good it feels when you work with that code. And so, time is up. In many sense, there is no more time. Time is up. And so it is for all those who have, once you have made all the choices, there is no more choice. It is just the way that is before you, for the maybe minor choices, but the most central choice is to serve God, to serve life, to respect God and all the faith, all the beliefs in relationship to divinity, for there is only one God, but there are many aspects, and all of this needs to be blended into this oneness and unity of love and inclusion, for all the truths will be readjusted and realigned as time goes on, as the inner minister chooses and decides that it is the time for the individual to realign to the higher truth. For you are the truth you seek, you are the divine God that you are seeking, you are the child, an extension of that source, a divine soul. And so the card of the day is the Two of Ariel. Maybe we'll take two cards. The Two of Ariel says you must find a balance. Running after more than one project at a time, make all work more enjoyable. So it is about finding pleasure in little things. It's also accepting the luck that may be coming to you. But it is also understanding that there's many things you can run after, but you do have to find this balance, this equilibrium. And then the next card is the Three of Ariel. It says do what you love, evolution, professional or artistic evolution. Work in team or cooperate. So there is a great deal that is coming up in terms of work. Each and every day we need to purify ourselves, we need to make ourselves better, find a way to improve ourselves. There's always little things that can make our life better if we accept to address us, sometimes go out of our comfort zone in order to do that. For the painting behind me is a painting that I finally finished. I had a hard time with the center, and now the center is done. I've advanced a lot in my new paintings, but they're really hard to show on video because it's like the painting kind of work as a whole, but then when you have to go inside to go close and to look closely, to look at all kinds of little things that are inside the paintings that you need to be really close to. So I'm looking forward to show those paintings physically so you can receive all those who are interested in art, they'll be able to sit physically, in Paris, in London, in many other places, New York, and so we'll soon be there. Looking forward to it, and many other places as well. I wanted also to speak about pulses. Pulse is like a pulse. We have a pulse. It is a heartbeat. A heartbeat is something that we have from the day of our birth to the day of our death. Our heart will beat. And it is our pulse, but the pulse have to be consonant. It is like a symphony of sounds that the pulse emits. So, but on the earth, the pulse are not consonant. Everybody's heart is not on the same tuning frequency. We want to move into this tuning frequency where everybody's. And the way to align that is to focus on the great central sun, the pulse of the great central sun. We can focus on the pulse of Mother Earth, the pulse of the sun, the pulse of the central sun, of the great central sun, and the pulse of the Creator. For everybody's emitting pulse, and the And so we want to tune in and align all those pulses, all those dimensions are aligned through the vertical axis. Well, I hope this message was interesting for you. I wish you a wonderful day. Thank you for everything, and I'll talk to you later. Salam.